In this video, we're just going to do more practice problem for higher order roots, section 6.7. So the first question is the cubed root of 64. You might know what this is right off the bat, but if you don't, you can always use the tree on 64, which is 8 times 8, 4 times 2. This is what I always do with roots when I'm stuck. This is a whole bunch of twos here. Looks like six twos. So we're looking for the cubed root of six twos. All right, since it's a cubed root, we're looking for groups of three. So there's a group of three, and there's a group of three. And for each of those, one factor will come out. So there's nothing left. So it looks like the cubed root of 64 is 2 times 2. 1, 2 from each of these groups, which makes 4. The fourth root of 81. So we'll do the same thing with the 81. The 81 breaks down to be 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. And we're looking for a group of 4. So there it is, the whole group of 4. So the fourth root of 81 is 3. The fifth root of negative 32. When you break down 32 with a tree, you end up with a whole bunch of twos, five twos. But since this radicand is a negative 32, we're going to put a negative on all those twos. So the fifth root of negative 32, this is negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. And we're looking for a group of 5, so the whole thing is your group of 5. So the fifth root of negative 32 is negative 2. All right, on number 4, we're working with variables. So when you work with a higher order variable, you just divide the exponent by the index. So this will be x to the fourth, 12 divided by 3. We're going to divide these variables by the index 4. So this will be x to the 1, y to the 4, z to the 6. Just divide each exponent by the index. We're dividing by 6 here, so this would be a squared, b to the 5th. On number 7, we're looking for the cubed root of 24. So we're going to break 24 down. It's 8 times 3, 4 times 2, 2 times 2. So there's our factors. 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. We're looking for a group of 3. And there they are, so these will come outside as a 2, but then we have to have this 3 left under. So 2 times the cubed root of 3. Be careful when you're working with higher order roots that you don't forget to write your index here, because if you leave it out, you're saying square root. And this was not a square root, it's a cubed root. On number 8, we're looking for the cubed root of 32. And we've already broken down the 32 a couple times. 32 is 5 twos. But since we're only looking for a group of 3, 3 of those 2's will come out. But these 2 stay in, and we multiply them back together. So 2 times the cubed root of 4. On number 9, we're looking for the 4th root of 80. So we might need to break down the 80. See what we get here. Bunch of 2's and a 5. Like 4 twos and a 5. So we're looking for a group of 4. So these 2s would be my group of 4. So they'll come out and my 5 has to stay under. On number 10, we've got the cubed root of 72. So I'm going to start by breaking down the 72. Which I know is 8 times 9. So I have 3 twos and 2 threes. And I also have x to the 9 and y to the 7. And I'm not going to break those up just because it's too much writing. So I'm looking for groups of 3. These 3s will have to stay in since they don't have enough. So a 2 is going to come to the outside. When I multiply those 3s back together, they'll stay on the inside as a 9. Now I'm going to divide these exponents by 3. 9 divided by 3 is an even 3 with no leftover. So this will be x cubed on the outside. 7 divided by 3 is 2 with 1 left over. So the 2 from the division goes here. The 1 left over will go in here. And this is the final answer. All right, 48. What can we get out of 48? We have 6 times 8. Which it looks like gives us 3 twos and a 3, 4 twos and a 3. X to the 11, Y to the 40, and a Z. So we're looking for a group of 4. So there they are right there. So that 2 is going to come outside, but this 3 has to stay in. All right, now with the exponents, I'm going to divide by 4. 4 goes into 11 twice. So that would give us x squared, and that makes 8, so there'll be 3 left over that have to stay in. 4 goes into 40 10 times with no left over, so that would be y to the 10th. And 4 can't go into 1, so that 1z has to stay on the inside. So we have a 250 here. So let's break it down. That's 25 times 10. So it looks like we have 2 times 5 times 5 times 5. Then we have x to the 5th, y to the 30, z cubed. All right, we're looking for groups of 3. So this 2 is going to have to stay in, but I can bring a 5 to the outside. That 2 is going to have to stay in. Now, we're going to divide these exponents by 3. So, 3 goes into 5 one time. So that would give me 1x on the outside, but there's 2 left over. So those 2 have to stay in. 3 goes into 30 10 times. So that would give me y to the 10. There's no leftovers. 3 goes into 3 one time with no leftovers. So that would give me 1z on the outside. And that's it. And now we have a fraction. So don't forget that you can divide these up into smaller pieces if you want to, but it looks like in this case, this is actually not the best way to do this because 27 is actually divisible into 54 evenly. 27 goes into 54 twice. 54 divided by 27 is an even 2. And so that's all we really need to do because there's no cubed root of 2.